So, Otto, we're getting ready to just go ahead and stimulate here, so just to let you know.
I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm a veteran. I serve in the United States Navy. Almost at the end of my contract, I remember that I went to see an ophthalmologist. His name was Lieutenant Commander Sermet. And I explained everything to him, that I was having a lot of problems standing on watch outside, and I couldn't see at nighttime. It was kind of difficult. So he performed different tests on me and put dilated my eyes, and finally he told me that I had retinitis pigmentosa.
Initially, peripheral vision or the side vision goes away, and then finally the central vision disappears. Patients who lose all the vision to the point where they could only see light or perhaps even no light are the most severely affected. So essentially what the Argus 2, number 2, retinal prosthesis is, it's an artificial retina or bionic eye. Because what it does is it converts the image by a camera that's mounted on the glasses that the patient wears and transmits it wirelessly to an implant in the eye, and that implant stimulates the retina, replacing the natural cells that have died off in the retina to produce an image that then goes to the brain.
When I was at the operating room, they asked me if I was afraid of the surgery, and I told them no, because I was in the best hands of the world, Dr. Gregori and her team.
That would be, that's me.
Okay. She's got a white coat on.
I have
on.
A white coat on.
Okay.
Let me see, is it better now? Is it a little easier on the eyes?
Yes.
Okay, that's because I'm wearing black now.
When they turned it on, I felt like a lot of explosions going around my eye, and just like fireworks. We went down the hall, and I was able to tell the windows, you know, the distance from one side of the frame to the other side of the frame, just like a vertical line, which is, to a lot of people, don't mean a lot, but to me, it meant a lot.
Giving a patient sight, restoring, and in this case, really doing something that we've never been able to do before, giving artificial vision. I mean, this is the beginning of, I think, a very new phase in ophthalmology where we're able to restore vision in someone who's lost it.
Thank you very much, guys.
Oh.
I work hard. I work so hard so I can see my son, at least the image of my son, because it's been 19 years. And I haven't been able to see him. But I thank you so much.